Come on. Ready for work? Ready?
How you going, guys? Curtis from Cutting Edge Engineering. Today's job, we have a tilt bucket off a 25-ton excavator. Customers brought it in with a couple of dramas. The floor of the bucket has got a lot of cracks in it and a lot of damage, and it's quite thin on the corners. So one of the main reasons these buckets wear out is operators don't take them off the machine when they should change to a general purpose bucket or a tooth bucket. They'll just leave this one on and try and dig heavy rock and tree stumps and all sorts of weird shit. And it generally damages the buckets. They're not built overly strong. They're only built for final trimming and doing batter work and drains and stuff like that. It looks like someone's been scooping concrete around with this bucket. A lot of concrete stuck inside of the corners. So one of the common issues is they wear out the heel of the bucket. Someone's already put a patch over the crack that's gone through here. So the crack starts there, comes out over here. And it's quite thin in here, so it's very, very worn out. Patches will get you out of trouble for a while, but they're never ever a really good fix. One of the other issues too, they tend to use them as a hammer, and they start to press the ground down trying to compact it, and that's what damages the floor of the bucket. So the floor has got a nice big dent in it, and you can see these cracks here. That's the result of using them as a hammer. Behind that crack will be a wear strip, and they always seem to crack along the weld line. You abuse your gear, going to cost yourself a lot of money in the long run. So to repair the bucket, we've got to turn it upside down. We're going to gouge the old floor out, well, pretty much the entire skin. Gouge all that out, we'll clean it up. I do have a new skin I've already had pressed up, so we'll then insert the new skin after everything's cleaned up. We'll weld that in place, weld on the new wear skins, job done. Why don't we just put a patch over the areas that are really, really thin, or just weld up the cracked areas? It's not really good practice to do that on a bucket that is off a dry hired excavator. So dry hire means my customer then hires this machine to another customer. Dry hire machines generally get abused because they don't own them. Rather than my customer ring me in a month's time and say, those patches you put on that bucket of mine have cracked, he's decided to do a complete new job on it, and we shouldn't have any issues out of this bucket for another 6,000 to 7,000 hours of machine hours. So we'll do it properly, we'll do it once. Customer's happy, his customer's happy, machine's not down, no one's losing money. A lot of people have been asking us about the air arc gouging or carbon arc gouging or arc air gouging. What air arc gouging is, it is a power source. It is a carbon rod with a copper outer layer on it to create the circuit. So that's an electrode. That's a 400 amp machine. You run them flat out when you're doing gouging, depending what size carbons you're actually burning. People often wonder where the airstream comes from to blow out the molten material. Well, it doesn't go through the rod. The airstream comes down the side of the rod, out those couple of jets there. So the air is fed into the handpiece via this button. You can turn it on and off. So you turn the air on and off from there. So after you create the circuit and you basically turn the metal into a liquid, the air then blows that liquid away, and that's what air arc gouging is. Quick way to remove material. It is very noisy, very toxic, so I wear a respirator when I'm doing it. That's basically carbon arc gouging. You can get the rods in all sorts of different sizes. You can get a 4mm rod, 6mm, 8mm, 10 and 12. I believe there are bigger. You can also use a flat gouging rod. The flat gouging rods are generally used for just cleaning up a welded area. If you want to take a hump out of a weld or you want to flatten things off, you can remove a lot more material with these very, very delicately compared to a round carbon. Jaws actually have provisions for a flat rod in them. I believe the arc air handpiece are the only ones that come with the flat notches in them. It can also hold around of any size, I think up to your half inch size rods. That's basically air arc gouging, as easy as I can explain it. Thank you.
see how thin that is. Very thin. Concrete down in that corner.
Righto guys, so I'm just going to touch on a bit of a safety thing about doing buckets and blades. Every time they push a load, they're pushing tension up the blade skin, and that is essentially bending that skin. So when you gouge it off, they tend to pop off. So take them off very, very carefully, take them off in sections. The reason I gouge in sections is to relieve the blade skin or the bucket skin as it sits in the frame of the bucket. Don't just run around the whole skin and then cut the last little piece if you're standing in front of it. You'll see I have left a little tab down here. So that there's going to hold that bottom skin in place. I have gouged both the sides. I will go all the way through the middle now, and then I'll cut that section there, relieve the skin. So if it does tend to spring, it's just I'm not going to be anywhere near it. People have been killed by doing this sort of stuff before. Be safe and keep your head out of the road. Thank you.
secret.
This is for me.
Ooh.
They must have seen the unwrapping presents with stupid knives.
Smith and Wesson.
Very nice. Very cool. Oh, nicely balanced too. Ooh, what could this be? Microwave and dishwasher set.
Nice. What is this?
So you can hang on to it.
Homie, what's this? Drop it. Drop it. What's this?
Get it.
Get it. Get it.
Righto guys, so we've completed all the work on the bucket for the prep side of things. Now we need to cut the skin to go inside the bucket. The piece of material we're going to use, it's actually a piece of 8mm Biz 80. It's a wear plate, high tensile material. First thing I need to do, I need to cut the green off. We bite with an extra 100mm aside when we're doing any sort of pressing. Sometimes the pressing companies need a little bit of extra material to fit in their dies. So after we've cut the green off the material, I'm going to weld a lifting lug to the back of the bucket so I can then bring it into the bucket with the forklift, lay it in place, and then we can go through and tack everything off and start dogging things into position. Once I've got the bucket skin tacked in place, it's pretty much just gonna be a weld out procedure. I will put all the wear plates just to go across the bottom of the bucket to avoid any wear while they're using the bucket. It's a sacrificial piece. They should be replaced every time they get worn out. Not many people do that, hence why we're doing a complete bucket skin. Righto guys, so we've completed the welding on the bucket now. As you could see by the clock in the background, it takes about 4 hours to weld one of these out. It's a pretty solid day's work to do a reskin like this on a bucket. It was well worth our customer's while to do the repair. This is a very good quality Australian made bucket. To replace this would be in the vicinity of $11,000 to $13,000. So you can see I've actually cut a couple of bits of plate that was the green material. I fit them between our wear strips on the bottom of the bucket. It's just going to reduce the material flowing across here doing any wear. It'll wear out these sacrificial pieces rather than wearing out the side of the bucket. That cheek plate there is quite thin at the moment. Our customer didn't want to change it out, so we did just give them the option of putting these plates on, and they were more than happy to go ahead with that. We're going to give our customer a call, let them know they can come and collect that. I'm sure they'll be very happy to get that back on site. Well, their customer will be happy to get it back on site. So she's done. Righto guys. No, I lost that.
You just kept saying the same things over and over again.
Yep.
Do you want to try that again?
The whole thing?
Sure.
Really? Righto.
Eight mil, can you say 8mm biz 80?
It's actually a piece of 8mm biz 80. So it's a wear plate. It's a good candidate for, fuck, shit. Off.
Right.
Oh, fuck. So the job's...
You had this, you said.
So now that the job's complete...
Oh my god.
Oh. So now that everything's complete, we'll just...
This is why we don't do endings. Okay.
So everything's complete on the bucket now. The customer's been not... fuck. Right, bring it back.
Oh my god.
Righto. Fuck, I'm losing it. Go again.
Just start from...
At the beginning.
Oh, righto.
She's done.
<I'm> stuck. Not coming out.
This is going to be fun. It's going to make a fucking nightmare.
That was a nice repair someone did. Dickhead.
Yeah, he'll let it go and you'll punch yourself. Oh god. Nope.
Get it.
Get it.
Get it. Drag that forklift around.
Go get it. Where are you going with it? Okay, see ya.